Are you curious about the new Luminar Neo that's coming soon? Do you want to know how the tools work, and does it do what it promises? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you three of the exciting new tools that will be inside Luminar Neo and tell you what I think of it so far. Hi, I'm Darlene with Digital Photo Mentor, and I teach beginning and intermediate photographers like you how to improve your work, right from capture in camera all the way through to the photo editing process and the finished image. Please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy it, and remember to subscribe to the channel. So without further ado, let's get started on this sneak peek of Luminar Neo. Before I get started and show you the tools, I want to remind you that this is what's called a technical build. So it's not even the beta version yet. It's just been given to Luminar and Skylum partners to be able to demonstrate a few of the tools. So this is not what the final interface is going to look like. It's just a sample so that we could show you a couple of new things. So I want to start with this image here, which you can see is covered in dust, which is on the sensor. This was shot several years ago with my Canon 5D, and the Canon was notoriously bad for collecting dust on the sensor, and I was also notoriously bad for not cleaning it. So I ended up with a lot of images like this, and I actually sent many of them to Skylum to actually help them develop this tool. So inside of this particular build, I can show you that there are three new tools. I'll show you Relight in a minute. But under the erase tool now, there are object removal buttons. So you can see that there are remove power lines and remove dust spots. So I'm just going to literally click this button and see how well it works. So this was real time, and you can see that not only did it remove most of the spots, it did a really good job, and it did it pretty fast. It's left a little bit of debris down in this bottom left corner here, but what I would call that is more of a smudge on my sensor, so I actually don't fault Luminar Neo in this case because it could have been interpreted as a cloud, but you'll also notice that it didn't remove the bird and it didn't remove this palm tree over here. So if I do want to clean this up a little bit, I can just use the erase tool like normal and get rid of some of these marks in the bottom corner and maybe these ones over here too. So if it misses anything that you want erased, you can take it out. But let's say it erased something you didn't want to be removed, you can actually put it back as well. So if I do a before and after, let's just say that this spot right here was actually a bird, okay? So I'm gonna hold down the backslash key, paint over it, and then I'm just gonna hit restore. And you can see that it brought back the spot that I just painted over, okay? So if that was another bird, now the bird would be visible. Let's look at another example. This one was pretty straightforward because all the spots were against a blue sky and pretty easy to see and to find. Let's see how it does on something like this that is more complicated in terms of the background. So I'm gonna hit remove dust spots and voila. So again, it sort of missed this stuff down in the bottom, but it looks more like a smudge. I can do some work to remove that. And over here as well. So I can just click and erase those real quick. I usually do erase one spot at a time, especially if I'm doing something major, because then it has a chance to run the algorithm and do a better job. Okay. It also didn't remove this spot on the background. And if I want this spot removed, I can sort of do this in little bits and stages and remove it as well. But what I want to show you is that it didn't do as good a job, let me zoom out a little bit, on this bottom right-hand corner here. You can see that the green lines in the background don't quite match up. So I have a little trick for that. If you literally just paint over both edges and click erase again, it does a pretty good job of filling in the straight line. You might have to try it a couple of times. There you see that it got it there. But I find that it does a really good job of filling it in and correcting it. So before and after. So previously, I would have had to do a lot of work with the erase tool or the clone tool to get rid of all those spots. You notice that it also didn't remove any spots on her, like mole or freckles that were on the person. So it's a pretty smart technology to know where the spots are. The next one I want to show you is the remove power lines. Okay, so same thing. I've got an image here where there's some lines going through and I'd rather not have them. So I'm just going to click remove power lines. If you've ever tried to do something like this, you'll know how hard it is and how much work you have to do cloning. Okay, so look at that. Now it did a really good job in most places. Once again, it might have missed a couple of places. Up here, I can see there's a little bit of a line there. So I can just erase that. And I can see a couple of lines that it missed here. But overall, I would say that I'm really impressed with the fact that it removed all of these power lines, even the ones intersecting through different objects. So you could see now, with a few clicks rather than a lot of cloning, I've got an image that is usable, right? It did miss the part in between her and the chickens per se, and that one I'd have to go and do manually. I anticipate that this tool is only gonna get better with each iteration of Luminar Neo, because this is just the beginning and the first stage, and I anticipate that these will get more powerful, all of these tools will get more powerful as we progress with Luminar Neo. Let's try it on this image. So I've clicked the remove power lines button, and once again, you could see that it's done a pretty good job, except for a couple of spots here in the sky. So I'm just going to paint over them and see if I can get rid of those. But Luminar Neo has literally done about 90% of the heavy lifting for me. And all I have to do is go in and clean it up a little bit. Okay? So a few brush strokes later, and I've got this. So before and after. With this one, I chose this image because I also want to show you the new relight tool. So with the relight tool, you can add brightness to objects which are closer to the camera and darkness to things which are further away, right? You can also do the opposite, right? Not sure when you would want to do that, but you can do the opposite and darken the foreground and lighten the background. But for this image, I want to lighten the man up and darken the background just a tiny little bit. Now you'll notice that I've pulled this depth slider up a little bit, and that controls how far the lighting is adjusted in your scene. So I want to adjust only the stuff in the far background behind him, and maybe not quite so much. There's also a dehalo slider. So halo would be if there's a white outline around the subject. I can try and adjust it. You can see that the light on the edges of him, as I pull it to the right, there's less of that sort of fringe light around him. So playing with these sliders a little bit, bring the depth down. You could see that I can get rid of the highlight that's around him, making it look more fake. I can also warm him up a little bit while simultaneously cooling down the background. Let's look at the before and after. So you can see that with a few clicks and a few sliders, I've removed the power lines and brought more attention and more light to the subject. Here's another before and after example. There's the before. He's very backlit and almost a silhouette in this image. And using the relight tool and the sliders that I just demonstrated a moment ago, I was able to brighten him up while simultaneously darkening the background. Now, if you're not a portrait or a people photographer, this applies to just about anything that you can photograph, including architectural, street photography, macro, anything you can imagine. So I'm gonna try it on this image of the Notre Dame Church in Paris, sadly taken prior to the fire, or happily, I guess. So you can see how the brightness near, as I adjust it higher, it's affecting just the cathedral, just the church and the steeple. And adjusting the depth, I can get more or less of the sky affected, and then play with the halo a little bit to tuck that in. Again, I think this tool is in its early stages and it's only going to get better, right? I think with 3 or 4 sliders to go from this to this is pretty exceptional without having to do any masking. And I can see the potential for this tool to do some amazing things the more it's developed. Here's another quick before and after example. The original image is really dark because the sky behind it is really bright. So it's a very high contrast scene. By using the relighting sliders and adjustments, I am able to brighten the arch while simultaneously darkening the sky. One more before and after. I think this tool is pretty amazing already, and it's only going to get better. I have one final example for you where I'm going to use all 3 tools and put it all together. So we're going to remove the dust spots, bingo. We're going to remove the power lines, bingo. And you can see that it did a really good job there. And then finally, I'm just going to bring a little bit of brightness to the foreground. And like I do with most other things and sliders, I take it all the way just so that I can see where it's applying. So I want it to apply sort of halfway through the pond here. And then I bring the amount slider back down. It just makes it easier for me to see where it's going. Then I'm going to warm up the foreground a little bit. And if I want to, I could darken the background, or in this case, the sky. Let's take a look at the before with the dust spots, the power lines, and the relight applied. There's the after. So less than 1 minute and I've got basically a finished image. Well, after having played around with Luminar Neo trial version a little bit and testing it on a few images, my first impressions are very good. Of course, there's room for improvement on all 3 tools, but this is a really early version just designed to give us a taste of what it's going to include in the beta and the final version. So if you're wondering when you'll be able to get your hands on Luminar Neo, it's available for pre-order now. Skylum is saying it will ship this winter and will include layers, the Relight AI that I just demonstrated, Luminar Share, which I'll tell you a little bit more about in another video, the dust removal and the power line removal, as well as a few other exciting tools when it first releases. Portrait background removal and mask AI are planned for a future update in early spring 2022. If you haven't already ordered Luminar Neo, the pre-order pricing is available until it is released. It also comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, which means you have 30 days to check it out and put it through its paces and decide whether it's for you or not. If you decide that Luminar Neo is not for you, you can just ask for a full refund. So it really is risk-free. So let me ask you, have you already ordered Luminar Neo? If not, what is your hesitation and what questions do you have? Please put them in the comment area below and I'll try to answer the best I can. If you're still unsure about whether or not to get Luminar Neo, watch this video now and I'll give you some tips and pointers on who I think Luminar Neo is for and who I think it's not for. I'll give you the down low straight up. See you next time.